Let's build an architect home page using the MaxiBlocks template library. Let's first preview the page we are going to make. Before we begin, we have listed all the elements we are going to use to make the page. You don't need this step as you can simply browse the library for ideas. Let's begin. Open a blank page. Select the blue plus button and select the template library block. Now toggle the Hero tab and select the Pro Hero 8 pattern. Next, we are going to load the footer. To update the content in the hero, we need to select the text and type in the text we need. The new text length is slightly different, so we need to update the column width values to fix the spacing. Let's make all three columns width 33.3% in the sidebar column settings. Next, we can toggle the responsive sizes to make sure they have been updated. For the smallest mobile size, we set the text columns to 100%. Toggle the sidebar settings and select the background layer. Click on the image to update it. To edit the two hidden images we see on hover, we need to toggle open the default list view in the top navigation tab. Toggle open the container, then toggle open the column section. Now select the image and replace it with your own image. Repeat the steps for the third image. Let's continue building the page. Click the green plus icon to load the template library again. This time we are going to select an icon pattern. Let's check it's loaded correctly. Yes, all looks great. Let's update it with our content and update the icons. Updating the icons is very easy. Select the Upload button. Use the search bar to search for an icon. Repeat the steps for the remaining four icons. Next, we are going to insert a story mix pattern. Story mix patterns are patterns that include a mix of design elements. Click on the image to update it. Now, let's adjust the padding to make it fit better on our screen. And we can also remove any unnecessary margins we don't need. Looking good. Let's now set up our architect portfolio. We can do this using an image pattern. Repeat the steps to launch and search for the pattern in the library. Remove all unnecessary paddings and margins. Next, we are going to repeat the steps again and add a call to action. Remove all unnecessary paddings and margins again. Repeat the step to add in our team section. Now that we have all our patterns loaded on the page, we can start making the final edits. First, our portfolio section needs a few more items. Click on the pattern. Select the duplicate icon in the toolbar. Let's duplicate it 2 times. Once you have duplicated the pattern, toggle over to the Advanced tab in the sidebar. Select the Flexbox settings. Let's give it a row gap of 30 px. Now we can copy and paste our content into the patterns. Next, we can update our portfolio section to reflect our own work. Click the Upload button in the toolbar. Browse and search for your images. The last and final step is to check the responsive settings. Mostly we just need to adjust some paddings here or there to make it consistent. Click Update and let's preview the live page. It looks great.